A date for Auckland's borders reopening will finally be revealed next week, but retailers will open to shoppers from midnight tomorrow. As previously signalled, Auckland remains on level 3 but moves to step 2 on Wednesday, meaning retailers open, as well as public facilities like zoos and museums. Up to 25 people can gather in groups outdoors. The top of the Northland, which has been in alert level 3 lockdown, will shift back to level 2 at 11:59pm this Thursday. The moves comes after another big surge in cases. 190 new community cases reported today, 182 in Auckland, 7 in Waikato and 1 in Northland. Another 4 from up north will be added to tomorrow's tally because they were reported after the deadline. 80 cases have been linked, 110 are still under investigation to determine any connection to current cases. 81 people are in hospital, including a 6-week-old baby, with 7 patients in intensive care or specialist units. Our coverage begins tonight with political editor Jessica Much-Mackay.
When Aucklanders wake up on Wednesday, they'll get another taste of freedom. Mixing and mingling outside in groups of 25 from multiple households will be the new reality.
Maybe have a barbecue. Yeah, that would be nice.
My kids over there are looking forward to seeing their friends.
I'm pretty happy about it, but it's a little bit scary, to be honest, knowing that it's going to mean that COVID's going to be really out and about in the community.
Probably getting back into a bit of sport too.
Gyms will still be closed, but outdoor classes can expand. And with just 47 days until Christmas, shopping's back with masks and social distancing.
We've had sort of 20 months of this now, and businesses have it ingrained in them about following all the protocols. This time it's a bit different. It's a 2-metre distancing, but they will be very keen to do the right thing because we are really keen to be open and moving ahead.
Despite record case numbers in the last 3 days, the Prime Minister's sticking to her guns.
In making this decision, we've also considered the ongoing mental and emotional strain of lockdown on Aucklanders and the impact on businesses. We do hope that this easing will relieve some of the pressure, and I again thank Aucklanders for the work that you're doing to keep the rest of the country safe.
Well, this is one of those classic trade-offs. I think everyone understands the need for Aucklanders to have some more freedom, but the consequence is we will see cases go up. So it's a balancing act.
Today, the Prime Minister also dangling a carrot for Aucklanders if double vaccination rates get to 90% or thereabouts.
There is a strong expectation from Cabinet that at 29 November meeting, Auckland will be in a position to move, a strong expectation, and we are going to be very pragmatic about that decision. We know the strain on Auckland.
That means the traffic light system from the end of the month, where your freedoms will be based on your vaccination status. But Aucklanders won't have to wait that long to find out when they can cross the border.
We'll look to make decisions on that shortly, and I expect to give an update on the date for the border reopening next week.
So we'll get a date for the announcement of the date next week?
No, next week I'll give you a date that the border will reopen.
The far north will drop down to level 2 despite 5 new cases today. It won't happen until midnight on Thursday to make sure it's not more widespread.
The person in hospital in Whangarei is a 6-week-old baby.
It'll be good for our small businesses, they really need it.
Well, it should be today, actually.
For Aucklanders, though, there's just over 24 hours to go.